Thank you, ma'am. A very good afternoon to respected ma'am and all my dear friends. I'm get a chance to express my view on classroom management concept, meaning and technique. And I'm going to express my views on this topic. Ma'am, can you share the PPT?
Yes. Okay, screen is visible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
My topic is classroom management concept, meaning and technique. So I am thankful of Professor Pratibha ma'am who assist me in this topic. The agenda of this seminar is I'm going to cover these topic in this seminar. Ma'am, second slide, please.
Yes, it is visible.
In this topic, I'm going to cover what... Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. In this topic, I'm going to cover what is classroom management, definition of classroom management, and third is why do students misbehave? Fourth is importance of classroom management, techniques, and conclusion. Okay, so these topics I'm going to cover in this seminar. So my first question is this. I'm going to give you a situation before starting my seminar. I'm going to give you a situation like if there are two teachers, teacher A and teacher B, both are well qualified, both are knowledgeable, both are talented, but the teacher A, she is able to control his classroom. She can complete all his syllabus. But the teacher B, she is not able to complete his syllabus and she is not going to, she is not very effective teacher. Can anybody tell me why is it like that? Why the differentiation is there?
Because she not use techniques.
Yes, very nice. Thank you.
She is less experienced than the other one. She is not trained enough.
Yes, very nice.
Not experienced such kind of class.
Yes. Thanks for your reply. All the replies are nice and they are giving me very nice replies. So I'm going to add one more point that the teacher A, she can manage the class very well. So she is giving her or his 100% to the student. On the other hand, teacher B is very capable. She is very talented, but she is not able to manage the classroom. For example, nowadays we are attending the virtual classroom, but ma'am is teaching us. But if we all are on our videos and phones and we will on everything and ghar mein we will watch TV and we will chit chat with our family members. Then what happened? Ma'am can able to teach us?
No, it's difficult for her.
Yeah, it's very difficult for ma'am to tell them everybody just close your video, just close your audio. We are not able to hear you. We will say like this. If we will not cooperate in this situation. So this is a virtual classroom. So we have to manage the things according to the virtual classroom. Okay. Ma'am, third slide, please.
Is it visible?
Have you seen there are two pictures? In one picture, teacher A is very happy. She's asking a question and second picture, the teacher is angry. The boys are jumping on the bench. They are not listening to the teacher. Yes?
Yes.
Why is it happening? Can anybody tell me?
The class was not interactive. So yes. Students are not attentive in the first picture.
Yes.
But in another picture, they feel that the atmosphere was so
voice is not
Rupi, your voice is not audible.
And the teacher is also very experienced, and he was interacting with each and everyone. That's why these two changes.
We can say, yeah, sure. We can say this teacher, teacher A is the lady.
Should I repeat? Should I repeat?
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah. Yes, you can repeat, ma'am.
Sure, I will repeat. In the first one, maybe that lady can't handle the class because of the lack of management. The class was horrible. And in another one, the interactive teacher and the interactive session made the students attentive.
Very nice. Yeah. I am totally agree with you that the in first picture where the lady is there, ma'am is taking the class and the students are very happy. They are listening the teacher very nicely. But in the second picture, the boy, the man, they are not listening the man. They are jumping on the bench. They are throwing the aeroplanes on him. So they are not interested to listen him. These two pictures are showing you the basic thing of classroom management. Is it it?
Yes.
Okay, now my next slide, ma'am. Can anybody tell me in their simple words, in their words, what is classroom management? What do you mean by classroom management? What is your thinking? What is your concept? Anybody? No problem, I will explain. Classroom management, as you can see in my slide, that classroom management refer to the wide variety of the skill. It means teacher should be have the variety of the skill. She has to be a storyteller. She should be a skill of dramatization. She should be a skill of singing. So she can cope up with the student very easily. She can make them to interest in their classroom. Not like when I enter in a classroom, I'll go on the blackboard and just start writing and tell them to just copy it. Not like that. Teacher should be, teacher means what? Teacher should be a complete package. Is it right? Am I right?
Yes.
Okay. Because sometime it happens, some of the students, they are able to understand what is written on the board, but some of the students, they are not interested, they are not bothering themselves to see on the board. It's true?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much. My point is that the teacher should... class management refers to the variety, wide variety of skills and techniques that teacher use to keep student organized, orderly, focused, attentive on tasks, and academically productive during the classroom times, during a class. Matlab, like if I'm going to take a math class in 6th or 7th standard. It doesn't mean ki I'm going in a classroom and I'll spend 40 or 45 minutes while only giving them lecture. I'm not teaching them anything. When I was in 9th or 10th standard, I remember my chemistry teacher, she taught us things through the songs, like that periodic table we learned through the song. Now I don't know, but that time we remember that thing, the formula, the factorization, A plus B square, that thing we will learn through the song because we feel interesting. Like a song we can learn, but later on we can understand the meaning of all these things also. Okay, is that clear? If anybody asks me anything regarding this, they can ask me in the session also.
Excuse me, Komal.
Hello.
She's Deepika.
Yes.
Yes,
you can ask. Archana. Yes, Archana.
Give the example of attentive on task.
what attentive on task.
I'm interrupting you. Please, participants, whatever queries you are having, you can ask your queries at the end of the session. Okay. Otherwise, this seminar, it will go much longer. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Now the next thing is saying that classroom management consists of techniques and attitude throughout which a teacher control their classroom. Means this is a technique and this is my attitude, how I'll control my classroom. Like sometime maybe I'm like a very strict teacher. I'll go in a classroom and tell them just submit your homework and complete that assignment. And I want to see this assignment on that day, that it, blah, blah. And then I'll leave the classroom. This is my attitude. Maybe this is my attitude. But on the other hand, I can say that the teacher technique should be different. Make them interesting. So make them we can say ki they will do the task on their own hand. As a teacher, it's our duty to give them support, but they need to do it themselves. Like if the small boy, jab humme chota baby hota hai, then they are crawling, they are not able to walk. Okay, so hum aisa thode ki hum unko leke chalna seedhe sikha dete. Not like that. We will teach them ki agar wo girte hain to hum unko thoda, it's okay, no problem, we will try it again. Like this, we will teach them. Okay, the same manner as a teacher, we have to teach our student also. Is that clear? Ma'am, next slide,
yes,
please.
Yes.
There are two definitions, which I, the first is Evertson Vincent, the action taken by the teacher to create and maintain a learning environment conducive for successful instruction. Okay, I'm going to explain this definition through an example. For example, I'm going to teach math. But before my math period, student came from PT class. Abhi bache PT karke, they are back in a classroom. So as a teacher, what's my duty? I will teach them chalo, abhi take out your math notebook and we will do factorization or we will do multiplication or something else. As a teacher, it's my duty to do this? Yes or no?
No.
No. Because they are coming from physical exercise. They are totally exhausted. Some, especially boys, are very much excited for the PT classes. So, wo abhi PT karke aaye, some of them are very thirsty. Some of them are very hungry. Some of them are sweating. Matlab sabka, there are different scenarios in the classroom, right? और उसी समय एज अ टीचर मैं बोलू नहीं नहीं चलो स्टार्ट डू वी विल डू सम्स 1 to 10 एंड आफ्टर 10-20 सम्स इज इन योर होमवर्क इट शुड बी माय एटीट्यूड
नो
थैंक यू सो वी हैव टू think that this should not be my attitude. We will give them time. As a teacher, we should give them time to come from that physical exercise. Abhi karke aaye, to humme wapas we need to come in a normal hone ke liye, we should give them time. Okay, just give them 5 minutes rest, give them drink break so they can drink water. If they want to go for loo, they can go. Just give them relaxation. Okay. And the second definition is supporting and developing orderly and productive classroom environment is the foundation of good classroom management. It's the same thing that supporting and developing orderly means ki hame support bhi karna hai. Matlab classroom management means what? Ki humko unko support karna hai jisse wo productive classroom. It's not like ki humne एक्सप्लेन किया और वो कोई भी चीज को बस लर्न कर ले नॉट लाइक दैट दे शुड बी इन देयर माइंड टिल द डेथ मतलब कोई चीज हमने अगर लर्न की फॉर एग्जांपल 2+2 हमने बचपन में लर्न किया था तो हमको वो अभी मरने तक एंड ऑफ द लाइफ लर्न रहेगा कि हाँ 1 में 1+ करते हैं तो 2 होता है 2 में 5+ करते तो 7 होता है लाइक दैट वी विल रिमेम्बर दैट थिंग एंड द एंड ऑफ आवर लाइफ यस
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Thank you. Ma'am, please, next slide.
Can I say something?
Just okay, now you gave the example of periodic table.
Yes.
Periodic table. But it was not learned to you, no?
Hello?
Now. So such things may happen. Are you getting my point? Are you getting my point?
Yes.
Whatever we learn in the childhood, it's not that we can learn it till.
I'm not talking about that periodic table. That is quite big. If we will remember 2-3 things, then I think ki hum usko wapas recall kar sakte. But the basic thing, I'm talking about the basic things. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Can I move ahead? Okay. Can I move ahead?
Yes.
Thank you. I'm talking about the classroom management, but my question is that why student misbehave? Why not? It's like that ki hum classroom mein gaye and everybody will sit quietly. They will listen to the teacher quietly and they will give me the answer. Why not this? Why this thing is not happen in a classroom? Can anybody tell me? Already in slide is shown, but I want your answers.
But because the teaching is not interesting for them.
Yes. Very nice. Thank you.
Because there is no interaction between teachers and students also.
Very nice. Thank you so much.
Teacher doesn't involve.
Because the teacher is standing on the podium and. Can I explain? Hello, can I explain?
Yes, you can.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Like if the teacher duty is not like that, ki I'll go in a classroom and I'll stand on the podium and just give my lecture like blah, 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 and then leave the class. It should not be like that. Why student misbehave? There characterize 4 points here. The first is bored. Student get bored. Aap unko sirf aise lecture pe loge, then they bored ho jate hain. We have to take a new steps through, matlab abhi only lecture is not important. Lecture is important, but we have to show the things through the slide. We will tell them ki now you can take participate in this, you can take up your participation in this. Testing rules. Sometimes students are very, nowadays students are very smart. They are testing our rules also. Let's see what teacher will do if I do this. Okay. The third is asserting independence. Unki independence ko bhi check karte hain. And fourth is seeking attention. Some of the students, they want teachers attention. For that, they misbehave. Okay? Next slide, ma'am.
Just wait for a while. Okay. This is the next slide, no? Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, can you read any point? Anyone can read any point so I can start from that point? Anyone?
Create a daily duties routine.
Yes. Create a daily duty routine. This you read just now? Okay, yes. I'll start from this point. Create a daily duty routine. Like when we go in a classroom, in a practical classroom, so we can see there are so many things we need to, as a teacher, we need to do. But agar aapne already duty decide kar di hai, like ki Ashok, you need to submit their almanac, Mukesh, you need to submit their homework books. So these are the daily routine, duty routine. And we should change their duties also. Ki ek bache ko bola, to it doesn't mean ki ek ko bola to then he say ki aray ma'am, to main ko hi bolte hamesha, I am the favorite. मैं उनका फेवरेट हूँ इसके लिए मैम ऑलवेज सेइंग मुझे ही बोलती है. नॉट लाइक दैट. वी हैव टू चेंज बिकॉज बच्चे जो होते हैं दे आर कमिंग फ्रॉम डिफरेंट बैकग्राउंड्स ना, तो उनकी थिंकिंग दे आर टोटली मतलब उनकी थिंकिंग थोड़ी सी डिफरेंट ही चलती है इन दिस मैनर. ओके, द सेकेंड इज क्रिएट क्लासरूम रूल्स विद योर स्टूडेंट ऑन डे वन. हैव यू हर्ड दिस वर्ड? फर्स्ट इम्प्रेशन इज द लास्ट इम्प्रेशन. Have you heard this?
Yes.
This is very true. First impression is the last impression. This thing is come in this point, like create classroom rules with your student on day one. Means when you enter in a classroom on first day, that time you should be attentive, you should be punctual, you should be presentable, you should be, what we say, नॉलेजेबल. तो ऑलरेडी आप टीचर हो तो आप नॉलेजेबल हो गए, बट ये सब थिंग्स शुड बी देयर. लाइक अगर हम पहले फॉर एग्जाम्पल हम कहीं अपॉइंट हुए एंड देन वी एंटर्ड इन अ क्लासरूम, तो व्हाट हैपेंड, हम फर्स्ट डे गए और हम इतना शाई है कि बच्चों से आई कॉन्टेक्ट भी नहीं हम करें और वी जस्ट गो इन अ क्लासरूम एंड जस्ट टेक अ चॉक और मार्कर एंड आई स्टार्ट राइटिंग ऑन अ बोर्ड एंड से जस्ट कॉपी इट. So, क्या इम्प्रेशन आएगा बच्चों पे? What they think about the teacher? They think, अरे, she is very lazy teacher. She don't know anything. What she is going to, how she is going to control us? We are very energetic student. She is not going to control us. Okay? ऐसा आएगा बच्चों के मन में?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
आएगा ना? तो we have to we have to create classroom rules with the student on the day one. हमें day one में ही उन्हें बता देना है कि we are not a lazy teacher. We are don't take us in a light way and don't think कि you can control teacher. Teacher can control a classroom. Okay. The third point is maintain the classroom rules, routine and schedule, but maintain flexible and leave room for fun. Okay, like we should maintain the classroom rules. Like if I am giving you the question, if I am asking you a question, so it doesn't means ki you have to give me the answer when you raise your hand. It doesn't mean ki aap hello ma'am and you can give me the answer. Not like that. You have to raise your hand, just wait for your turn. Some of the student it happens in a classroom, there are so many students, those who are very smart, they know everything, because some student they can complete the topic at their home. Pari, they will complete that topic, and the day when teacher will start that topic, they know everything, so they can raise their hand very nicely. Oh, ma'am, I know everything. So this is not, this should not be done in a classroom. We should maintain the rules, and the thing is flexible and leave room for fun. Maintain flexible. It means like my rule is to complete the homework on the due not before. No, sorry, after due date, I'm not going to accept your homework. It doesn't mean I'm not going to accept your homework after due date. मतलब कुछ इमरजेंसी हो गई, ड्यू टू सम इमरजेंसी द स्टूडेंट इज नॉट एबल टू कंप्लीट हिज होमवर्क. इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि मैं तो तुम्हारा अभी करूंगी नहीं, एक्सेप्ट ही नहीं करूंगी. यू नीड टू गो टू द ऑफिस एंड टॉक टू द प्रिंसिपल, कॉल योर पेरेंट्स, देन ओनली आई कैन एक्सेप्ट योर होमवर्क. It should not be like that. We will talk to the student why it's happened. Is there any emergency? Is there any problem? You are not able to complete your task. Okay, so it should be flexible. When students are engaged and excited about learning, less management problems arise. Jab bacche bahut zyada, when students are very much excited और engaged होते हैं, तो वो बहुत ज्यादा आप उनको ऐसा fun भी करा दोगे तो they are not ready to listen you. फिर वो teacher को take me for granted ले लेते हैं, like कि अरे she is very friendly, she is not going to give us punishment, she is not going to say harsh word to us, like that. Okay, three key rules. Use your inside voice. Wait your turn, raise your hand. These are the three basic rules which need to be followed in a classroom. Okay, always have a plan, always have a backup plan. Like you should have to be a backup plan bhi hona chahiye. For example, I'll go in a, every day is not possible ki har din sab, I'll give you this, I'll explain this topic in a different example, like as we all are lady and everything, every day is not same for us. Sometime we are down, sometime we are up, sometime hume kuch cold hai, cough hai, something has happened, sometime our mood is not good. So what happened when we entered in a classroom, it doesn't mean ki hum roz hi aapko, we will show roz hi ek jaisa padha sakte, not like that. So we should always have to be plan B ki jab we are down, hamari tabiyat theek nahi hai, but we are not able to take leave, so on that day we will give them written work or we will take their practice, we will take their revision. Okay, is that clear?
Deepika, you have only 5 to 7 minutes more. Huh?
Hello, is that clear?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Ma'am.
Okay.
Get the student involved. Have them take part in the designing and smooth running of the classroom. When you make a rule of your classroom, that time take a help of the student also, so they can feel ki ha baba humko bhi pooch rahe hai, aisa nahi ki apna hi khud ka she is doing. Okay, then create an atmosphere of respect in which children feel safe, valuable and want to take a risk. You should create an atmosphere of respect in a classroom. Aapko day one mein hi respect ka atmosphere create karna hai class mein, so they can understand ki ha this thing is wrong, we should not cross this limit, we should not go like that. Okay, be aware of all the school resources. We should know what are the resources are available in the school, like kya kya school is providing you. You can use all the resources. Do not ignore any negative behavior. If any child is behaving negative, aapke bahut bar bolne ke baad still he is doing the thing badly, she is matlab usme kuch improvement is not going on, so you have to take a initiative. You have to talk to the student ki what's your problem, why you are behaving negative. Okay ma'am, please next slide.
I think Deepika, the importance of classroom management, it is not there in your topic, so I think you should move ahead with the techniques.
Okay, change the slide ma'am.
Okay.
And okay, now next is techniques. We already talked about so many things. Now we will come on the techniques. So there are 6 techniques. वैसे तो मैंने बहुत सारे techniques I read it out, but 6 I wrote it here. Like what is the first technique to control the class? Like how to manage the class nicely? First is time is short, so I'll explain. After that, you can ask me a question. Eye contact. Eye contact means what? You should, when you entered in sometime, I already saw so many teachers, those who are joining first time, they will not eye contact to the students. When they go in a higher class, wo bachcho ko eyes mein dekhte hi nahi hai, because student are seeing them like, are she is a lady, she is abhi to nahi nahi aayi hai, ye kya padhayegi, like that. Some of the student, they are making their concept like that. Okay. Proximity control. Proximity control means you should maintain the what we say, maintain the aura or maintains the difference. Like this is my area, you should not able to enter in my area, and you should be in your area. Okay. Silent signals. Silent signals means when you enter in the classroom and classroom is making noises, doesn't mean you will shout, stop talking, don't talk, sit quietly, not like that. What happened? Agar aap aise chillaoge to aap bhi pura drain ho jaoge, aapki sari energy will gone. Okay, you are not able to teach them, so you will first, from first day, it's very important that you will make a silent signal. Like if I show you one finger, it means you will keep finger on your lips, and if I show you two, it means you should do head down. If I say three, it means you should take out your copies. Okay, Fourth is quiet and gentle reminder. Your reminder should be gentle. It should not like that ki nahi complete nahi kiya tab to baba you are going in a office, principal office and he is going to punish you. Not like that. Usse kya hota hai, student will aur bhi zyada bacche wo ho jate, they are not going to open with you. वो उनको लगता है अरे ये तो टीचर ऐसे ही बोलती है, अभी ले जाएगी प्रिंसिपल के पास, अभी तो मम्मा को लेटर चला जाएगा और हम लोग रेस्टिगेट हो जाएंगे, लाइक दैट. तो योर रिमाइंडर शुड बी जेंटल सो दे कैन इजली शेयर देयर प्रॉब्लम विद यू. ओके, रीडायरेक्ट स्टूडेंट अटेंशन. सम टाइम इट्स हैपन वी आर ऑल्सो फेसिंग द सेम प्रॉब्लम. हमारा अटेंशन थोड़े देर के बाद ऐसे गायब हो जाता है. तो टीचर्स ड्यूटी इज टू, अभी थोड़ा सा पढ़ाया तो बीच में लाइक थोड़ा सा फन कर लिया, जस्ट क्रैक अ जोक, टेक देयर नेम्स इन अ जोक, सो दे फील कि अच्छा मैम ने मुझे वो किया है, लाइक दैट. सो ओके, प्रोवाइड पॉजिटिव रेनफोर्समेंट, लाइक गिव देम अ पॉजिटिव रेन एनफोर्समेंट. मतलब उन्हें हम पॉजिटिव वो दे, नेगेटिव हमें नहीं देना है. ओके मैम, नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. एंड दिस इज माय कंक्लूजन. क्लासरूम रूल्स एंड प्रोसीजर्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट, बट दे मे वेरी फ्रॉम वन टीचर टू अनदर टीचर. इट डजंट मीन कि मेरे क्लासरूम के जो रूल्स हैं वो बी टीचर के भी हो. Doesn't mean हम अपनी क्लासरूम का मैनेजमेंट अलग तरह से करते हैं और दूसरे क्लासरूम का टीचर अपने क्लास का मैनेजमेंट अलग तरह से करता है. सो इट शुड बी डिफरेंट बिकॉज हमारी स्किल्स आर डिफरेंट. मेरी शायद ड्रामेटाइजेशन मेरी अच्छी है और दूसरे बंदे की शायद सिंगिंग अच्छी है या उसकी वॉइस इतनी अच्छी है कि वो उसे बोल देते तो स्टूडेंट कैन लिसन देम वेरी नाइसली और वो बच्चों के दिमाग में आ जाता है कि नहीं इस टीचर ने बोला है तो वी हैव टू डू इट. ओके एंड रूल्स एंड प्रोसीजर टिपिकली इनटू सेवरल कैटेगरीज इंक्लूडिंग जनरल एक्सपेक्टेशन फॉर बिहेवियर बीइंग एंड एंडिंग दिस डे और पीरियड. इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू इन्वॉल्व स्टूडेंट इन द डिजाइन ऑफ क्लासरूम रूल. वॉट एवर आई सेड दैट व्हेन यू आर मेकिंग अ रूल इन अ क्लासरूम यू शुड टेक अ you should take them sorry you should make them to take part in your rules. Okay, I think I'm done. Next slide ma'am. Thank you for listening me.
Thank you Deepika and congratulations to you for conducting really very interactive and nice demo. Okay, so if audience, if you are having any query, please ask to Deepika. Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes. Yes.
Here that technique points are there, no, ma'am. That once time you show, no, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. See whatever questions yes. you're having, please ask very fast because we are having only 5 minutes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Ma'am, here that provide positive reinforcement.
Okay.
What is mean by that reinforcement?
Okay, Deepika, please answer.
Provide positive. Provide positive reinforcement means we should मतलब उनको सुदृढ़ बनाना है, उनको strong बनाना है. मतलब ऐसा नहीं कि like I've given you the example कि हमें बच्चे को वो नहीं करना है कि अरे बाबा मैं तुमको help करता हूँ, अगर तुम्हें ये सब नहीं आता है तो I can help you. Not like that. We have to make them positive reinforcement. हमें उनको इतना capable बनाना है कि अगर for example अगर हम बच्चे को मैथ्स पढ़ाते हैं तो हमें उनको ये भी सिखाना है कि जब शॉप पे जाना है तो इतना पैसा दिया तो कितना पैसा आपको वापस लेकर आने, लाइक ओके. तो तो इट शुड बी पॉजिटिव रीइंफोर्समेंट, मतलब स्ट्रांग बनाना है बच्चों को स्टडी वाइज.
ओके दीपिका, आई वांट टू ऐड समथिंग इन दिस. सी पॉजिटिव, जस्ट अर्चना, जस्ट ट्राई टू रिकॉल लेसंस और फीडबैक गिवन बाय द टीचर एजुकेटर्स आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ एनी लेसन. ओके, सो इट कैन बी माइक्रो टीचिंग, इट कैन बी इंटीग्रेशन, इट कैन बी प्रैक्टिस टीचिंग. सो वन रिमार्क वॉज देयर, दैट इज रीइंफोर्समेंट वॉज गिवन बाय अ टीचर. ओके, एंड द रीइंफोर्समेंट इट शुड बी पॉजिटिव रीइंफोर्समेंट. सो reinforcement, it is nothing but in Hindi or in Marathi we called it as a prabalan. It's a kind of motivation. So as a teacher, you should motivate your student in a positive way. For example, suppose just now you ask one question to Deepika, and suppose you are a teacher and she is your student, but yes, her answer is not 100% wrong, but she tried her level best. Okay, and her answer is 50% correct. So instead of saying no, your answer is wrong, so this can be a negative reinforcement for the Deepika. But instead of that, yes, you tried very best, you are partially correct. So this kind of statement given by a teacher, that can be a positive reinforcement for a student. Understood? Even yes, whenever we are saying yes, good try, so these praising words, they are also nothing but the positive reinforcement. Okay. Deepika, I want to ask one question to you.
Yes.
See, in faculty have you attended faculty development program of our college? Yes, we have conducted 7 days faculty development program.
Yes.
Okay. Shinde sir, he has introduced one learning management system, that is Edmodo. Okay. So do you really think that Edmodo, it can helps in classroom management? And if yes or no, just justify.
It can classroom management. I think no.
No, then why?
Because classroom management का basic rule ही ये है कि हमें class, मतलब कैसे nowadays virtual classes going on ना, तो Edmodo पे भी virtual things are going on. हम ऐसे physically बच्चे हमारे सामने नहीं है, they are not sitting in front of us, so we are not able to control, मतलब how can we control them on Edmodo, because
okay, I want some other answers now. This question is for the audience. See, if your answer
yes,
is yes Archana.
Ma'am, Edmodo is useful for the secondary level, ma'am, secondary level students, ma'am, not for the all classes.
See, because of this pandemic effect, nowadays we are very used to of the learning management system. So we are taking virtual classes, and this Edmodo learning management system, just try to recall that the parents, they can also log in that system, right? So yes, they can check progress of their own kids. So yes, so from my point of view, I can say that can be one technique of classroom management also, because if the parents are checking their regular progress, so automatically they will put more attention on their learning.
Yes.
Okay. We'll give one more example. Suppose now, just I told you, I'm going to put your videos on YouTube. Okay. So if I'm going to record your videos, and YouTube is having access to everyone. Okay. So if you think that my video will see by anyone. Okay. So automatically you'll try to give your best. Okay. So this can be one technique of the classroom management. So here, this is not actual classroom management. Just I'm telling about the seminars. Okay. So how to have control on the seminars. Okay. Okay. Deepika, one more question for you. Just tell me, what do you mean by learning environment? Because in definitions or meaning of classroom management, repetitively you told us about the learning environment. What does it mean?
Learning environment means, ma'am, aisa environment jahan pe hum cheeze learn kar rahe, not to distract. Like, agar hum unhe formulas, we are teaching formulas to the students, so they can apply that formulas in their sums.
Can
or
you
like in
See, learning environment means we have to create environment in such a way that student can eagerly learn in that situation.
For example,
instead of just teaching the deductive methods, see, in the mathematics, most of the time teachers used to, they are supposed to use deductive method while teaching any concept. Okay. But instead of that, if we use the inductive method, if we take some activities regarding the same topic, so that can be a learning environment. That can be the creation of the learning environment for the students. And as you told that, it is not possible to retain attention of the students for the longer time. So for that, the teacher is supposed to use different teaching aids. See, recall the micro teaching lesson of stimulus variation. In that, you are going to use different stimuli, because it is proved that attention of a single child, he cannot pay attention more than 8 minutes on a particular thing. So simultaneously, yeah, as a teacher, you're supposed to use different stimuli. For example, you can use blackboard, you can use charts, you can use presentation, you can use activities. Okay, so as a teacher, you're supposed to use different techniques. So that can be one method of the classroom management. Okay, so there are different techniques of classroom management. These are only not 6 or 7 techniques of classroom management. So you'll get n number of techniques on internet, or in some books also. Okay, audience, you have any question? Yes. Okay, should we stop here? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and one request to everyone. Suppose your topic is, I gave you particular topic. So just try to stick your own topic. Agar aapka topic, see, instead of the concept, Deepika, you should equally focus on the techniques also. Lekin usne bahut sara time jo tha uska concepts ko clear karne mein gaya. So that can be a time management. So stick to your own time management. Okay, this is my request to everyone. Okay, ma'am. Okay, student, thank you so much. Now I'm going to end up this session.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much.